sun's shining, the birds are singing, and I'm on another solo boat night, so I've got my night all planned. I've got my longbow, I've got a quiver full of arrows, and I'm going to go for a shoot for a couple of hours. So loose a few arrows off, then I'm gonna come back, go for a walk, then I'm gonna cook my dinner, I might watch a movie in a bit, so I've got my night all planned, so I'm really looking forward to it. Got a wooden shield at just 20 yards up or that. Shot, sir. Okay, get the arrow in the correct position. Hold the bow in between my legs. Knock the arrow. Piece of leather on the back of the string. Bang. Now these ones are really interesting. Look at them beauties.
Is that a miss? Oh dear. What an amateur!
Got none left! All my arrows are gone in my quiver! The good thing about archery as a hobby is that you get your projectiles, you put them back, you fire them again. Unless you lose them in the grass or they snap or you damage them, then unlike other shooting sports where you've got, you know, firearms, air rifles, paintball guns, whatever, that projectile's gone. These are quite expensive, ranging between, well, if you make your own, I make a lot of my own arrows, so you're talking a couple of quid to up to 8 quid each, but you get them back when you shoot them, so it's a cheap hobby.
Oh, miss, amateur. Look at that. Oh, that's pinned well and truly to this bale. Oh, oh dear. Like a porcupine knot.
Now, I wouldn't like be holding this shield for defense purposes. It's only thin ply though, it's not a medieval replica or anything, so it's just a thin ply one I knocked up for a bit of fun, a bit of a target, but serves its purpose and I'll keep shooting it till it falls to pieces. These are absolute sons of bitches to get out. Right, let's have a few shots for distance. See how far we can get. Nice straight line that was. I've got lighter and heavier arrows and different lengths and all sorts, so it's not really a proper experiment. It's just a play about, see how far they go. That was a good one. Like that one. Beautiful shot that was. That was good. Right, I'm going to have a few shots from right back there. It's about 140 yards. I've just moved the camera. I hope I don't hit the camera. I'll just see if I can get any arrows falling near the camera. I just have three shots. If I do, I do. Right, big long walk. Hope my battery don't go flat. Okay, that's where the camera was, look. And then we've got one straight in front of it. You know, 3 yards in front of it, there's an arrow. And then they're all dotted about. Even got my name on these ones, look. Yeah. There's some I made. It was a nice day, but now that big nasty black clouds forming up there. Yeah, so I've got all my arrows back. Muddy, clean the mud off. Give them a bit of oil on the ends of the points, good to go.
Dead cormorant face down.
I don't know what's killed that, or whether it was just old or whatever. I'm gonna fish it out, have a look, see if we can see anything.
It's dark outside, but lovely and warm in here because I'm cooking. Tell me that doesn't look good. Yummy, yummy.
This is nice. It's better than a tin of soup or something like that, but I can't be asked to cook a lot of the time, so because I know I've got all the washing up to do, so. But yeah, this is a nice candlelit dinner for one, I must say. Well done, chef. Well done, chef.
Oh, that was ridiculously nice. Time for the washing up now. There's some owls hooting tonight. It's a nice clear night. It'll be cold though later. Hear that? Lovely owl.